Hola, SAP developers. I'm really excited to share with you a functionality that was recently released by the SAP process automation team. There is a new actions editor, which is available as part of the actions project. In his blog post series, Vivek highlights the changes introduced in an actions project. For example, the actions editor allows you to select and maintain the paths and operations of an API that you want to make available as part of an actions project. Not just that, but there is also a connectivity option in the UI that allows you to test the action by selecting a BTP destination or entering server details manually. If you aren't familiar with Actions Project in SAP Process Automation, I recommend checking out this TechEd S session where Chana explains to us how you can easily communicate with other systems using Actions Project. She also published a blog post that covers how to do this. Remember that the starting point for an Actions Project is in an Open API specification document. You can find Open API specification documents for all the publicly available APIs of SAP products in the SAP API Business Hub.
The SAP Cloud Connector is an essential piece of software if you want to make connections between on-prem systems and the cloud. In particular, of course, between on-prem SAP systems and SAP Business Technology Platform. There's a new release of the SAP Cloud Connector available now in the usual place. This release is version 2.15, and it comes with a number of enhancements. Too many to mention here, but here's just a few highlights. You can connect an on-prem system with a service within a Kubernetes cluster on SAP Business Technology Platform by using a service channel. Think of a service channel as a way of providing access from an external network to specific services on SAP BTP. There are new possibilities relating to principal propagation, which can now be used not only for business users, but also for technical users. And there have also been some security improvements and enhancements in the area of the UI for the SAP Cloud Connector. You can read more about all of these improvements in Marco's blog post.
Hi folks, come and meet us at TechEd 2022. My name is Sven Denneken, and TechEd is your chance to listen to the latest news about SAP technology. This to get educated and engaged, and to meet and hear from SAP experts, clients, customers, and partners. We have a dedicated track for SAP S/4HANA called the Digital Transformation with SAP S/4HANA, which actually is supported by three subtracks: Rise with SAP, Move to SAP S/4HANA, and Extend, Integrate, and Embed Intelligence into SAP S/4HANA. This all covered in 18 lectures, 3 breakout sessions, and 9 workshops. During the event, you will get all the deep dive and hand-on sessions you need to explore SAP S/4HANA, regardless of the deployment model. You will also hear directly from our customers and partners who will join some of the sessions to share their insights to their digital transformation with SAP S/4HANA Cloud. Look out for more details on the SAP TechEd website, and I'm looking forward to see you there.
The latest SAP BTP Innobytes is out. This is for October 2022, and as usual, it consists of a short video accompanied by a blog post with lots of details. In this blog post, there's details about the SAP integration suite, specifically relating to a more harmonized user experience. There's a look at time traveling analytics with SAP HANA Cloud calculation views, which sounds extremely exciting. And there's also an explanation of a new commercial model for SAP Data Warehouse Cloud. Check out all the details, which includes a link to the video in Cecilia's blog post.